Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. In today's game, we have a matchup with two of the best receivers in the NFL, both with huge games against each other in the black and blue division of the NFC North. It's Jordy Nelson going up against Calvin Johnson. Now we'll take you out to Lambeau Field, where Jim Nantz and Phil Sims have the call.
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we're getting set for an NFC North matchup as we join you from historic Lambeau Field.
Hello, friends. Jim Nantz along with Phil Sims. You just have to love these types of games because there's just so much bad blood. There's such a deep rivalry here. The spirit is intense, and these teams will do anything to beat the other team.
Well, they will, and we know that. It's just more attention to the details for the players during the week, and also you got to be ready for trick plays. The coaches, they want to try to fool the other team, give their team an edge, so you got to be ready for fake punts, fake kicks all during the game.
And Sam Martin is set now to kick it away. The Packers are back deep, waiting for the kick return. This heated rivalry matchup is underway. He'll take it from the one. And the tackle is made. The offense will start their drive from about the 31. And here's a quarterback coming onto the field who has plenty of experience under his belt.
Yep, there's no doubt. He is the man in charge, and he shows it just the way he handles himself. And that's why he plays so well. That's why he's in this game today.
The Packers snap it at the 31. Toss to the outside. Has the first down and a whole lot more. Setting the tone here early with the big running play that time.
They took advantage, Jim, of a defense that's out of position. Nice job by the running back taking advantage of it, and he picks up big yards.
Lacy lines up in the backfield. First and 10. Rodgers over to Nelson.
This is one of those guys, when you talk about receivers, no matter what, he is always open. If the coverage is tight, don't worry. Throw it out there. He'll make a play.
This play set up by the long gainer. They'll run it off the toss. What a first series. Touchdown. That's a terrific start for this team, Phil, with the early touchdown.
Yeah, just the way they planned it. Man, you get in there during the week, you practice, you look at all that film, and then you say, here's going to be our starting plays for the game. You go out there, you run them, and you score. That is a great feeling.
The point after try is in the books. Jones gonna take a knee, so this will come out to the 20. Here's the man who leads the Lions' high-octane attack, quarterback Matthew Stafford.
Matt Stafford has shown many people that he has all the talent to get it done on the field, but what he's got to start doing now is leading the football team. You not only got to play well as a quarterback, but you got to lead the players and make them better too.
The Lions are at the line of scrimmage and loading up that line with an extra tight end. Bell's going to take the handoff now. As I look at this Lions offense, Calvin Johnson can't help but stand out.
There are not enough nicknames for Calvin Johnson. When you look down the field, you can pick him out right away. You cannot believe somebody this big and this fast can be a wide receiver in the NFL. He is truly special.
Bell with the grab. In the end, it picks up only a yard. A look at the defensive starters and a good look at the secondary, a group that could be the difference in this game today. Third and six. It's caught by Fuller.
This team, one of the better tackling teams in the NFL, and they play the situation perfectly. They give up the short completion. They come up and make the tackle. Now we have a fourth down.
Hyde's got it on the return. Stiff arms to stay on his feet. Lawson's there to make the tackle. That return's good for about 21.
Hyde's able to show off his talent on that punt return that time. What speed and quickness that allows him to break through some of that coverage and picks up good yards.
The Lions defense, let's see where they are mentally here, Phil, after allowing a touchdown.
Well, they got to have some motivation after that last drive. It was so poor. It's about discipline. We didn't see it from their defense. So this time, go out there and just do your job.
Going for the deep ball. Snags it right out of the air with one hand.
Impressive play, no doubt about it. And nowadays, from these receivers, we see one of these every single game. Hey, these guys are good.
They come to the line, and it's first down. Toss to the outside. Shakes off the hit. That's a gain of seven.
Nothing like a running back who fights for every extra yard. When you get that extra yard or two, what it does, it just creates better situations for your offense.
Aaron Rodgers will be under center.
Second down, three to go.
In his hands, complete, touchdown. Bill, everything is going right for this team at this point. We're still in the first quarter. What must the coach on the other side be thinking?
He's thinking, hey, can we get this game over with? And can I get out of here? He can't believe it. After a full week of hard work and preparation, and to come out and play like this, this is absolutely uncalled for.
The Packers getting set to kick it away. No return here. This will be coming out to the 20. The Lions offense is on the field, hoping to erase the memory of their last drive, which was completely unproductive, a quick three and out.
Yeah, it was. I don't know if they can erase this defense. This defense is pretty good. We saw that in the last drive. They got good players, and they're pretty excited, so this is going to be tough on the offense.
First down at the 20. They'll run it here. Bell is tackled down. Second down and 10. Bell's got it on the handle. Gets about 9 on the play.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
The first quarter is behind us, and we'll step aside as you watch the NFL on EA Sports. The Lions on offense here to start the second quarter. Third and one coming up. Bell lined up as the single back. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
And as far as the football team up, the defense, third and short, they stop the run. keeps the offense short of the first down, and look at the excitement on the defensive side.
Hyde's going to take this one from the 18. Gains 11.
Aaron Rodgers trotting out onto the field into the huddle.
It's been a heck of a day for him up to this point, partner.
Well, we expect nothing less. He's an excellent player. When he gets a chance and you give him an opportunity to make a play, he seems to always come through with it.
The Packers have it at the 29. Going deep. Clutch catch. He's in the clear. Going to take it home for the touchdown. Can you believe this score?
Hard to believe, isn't it? Here in the NFL, you don't see this too often, especially early in the second quarter, where you think one team has absolutely no chance of winning this game today.
The Lions' return team has been on the field way too often today as they are getting blown out. The score's 21-0. To get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt as they take the field here. Do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of information out there in that short drive, Jim, and you do that by showing different formations and plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three and out business.
Well, it's a bad business to be in. I know. I get in a lot of bad businesses.
The Lions will take the snap from the 25. And it's just thrown away. The offense needs 9 here on third down after that incompletion. 3rd and 9 is the call. Stafford's going to take the snap from the shotgun. One thing that's truly evident here is that this has been a defensive unit that's been the aggressors and setting the tempo in this first quarter plus.
Always a good thing for your football team when your defense is out there playing fast and being reckless and being aggressive. And they've done all three so far here in this game.
Hyde's going to take this one from the 16. That return's good for about 18. The Packers have tried to stretch the field vertically, and they certainly have. Rodgers' arm is one of the best in the league.
Long passes down the field that are completed. It's still one of the prettiest plays in all of sports. It just looks majestic, and man, has he been sharp today. This type of play. Of course, everybody would. When you get a good punt return, that's what you want. And of course, it helps when you have an explosive punt returner back there.
The Packers have it at the 34. Jones has got it on a pass, had some heat on it. Third catch today so far. The Packers have done a fantastic job here of getting the football to one of their key targets. Jones has been a favorite target, Phil.
He has. And listen, when you have that kind of talent on the outside, you got a quarterback that can put it on the money. The offensive line, they're having an outstanding day, too. It adds up to a lot of receiving yards. What a wonderful route by the receiver. Terrific throw by the quarterback, and he catches it. And it's a long game, but just short of the end zone. Nice play by the offense.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. Walker's there that time for the tackle. We've hit the 2-minute warning here in the first half. Welcome back. Halftime just a couple of minutes away as we resume play out of the two-minute warning. Second and goal to go from the one.
Well, I tell you, it's getting ugly out here.
Nice throw by the quarterback that time. Put it right on the money. Not a big window. It doesn't matter to him today. Great control of the football. Put it right in there for the touchdown.
The Lions, I'm sure, wanted to avoid giving up points on that drive just before the half. But now they'll have even a bigger hole to dig themselves out of in this one. The scores 28-0. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Lions are experiencing a little bit of a drought here offensively, having gone three straight possessions without a score. What do you think needs to be done to buck that trend here, partner?
I'd say it's a little more than a drought. This is some awful offense, and there's many things you've got to do. You've got to tell your offensive line to pick things up. When the offensive line is aggressive, it gives all the stars a chance to succeed, and that's what they got to do here. Offensive line, get it going.
They get set quickly, ready for another snap. Second down, two to go. Tate has the reception. That's another reception. Give him two. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. This will go incomplete. He was trying to find Ebron.
Man, the quarterback, the coaches, his teammates, everybody loves to see a player give that type of effort. How about the receiver just going all out to make the catch? Doesn't quite get there, but the effort is outstanding.
Second and 10. And he just tosses it incomplete.
In a situation like this, third long, if you're the defense, catch him by surprise and blitz.
Third down now. The Lions will set up. The 44 is the first down line. Stafford's going to take it from the gun. That ball has been picked off. The intermission is right around the corner, and they continue to smother the opposition.
Hey, they want to go in at halftime, Jim, with a big zero on the board for the other team. They deserve it. This is a tough defense that plays hard, and they have been whipping some tail out here in the first half.
The Packers signal for the timeout, and that's the first one they've used. At the 31, here we go. Rodgers will have it in the pistol. First down at the 31. Great grab there. Snags it with one hand. Phil, that's one of the best one-handed catches we've seen all year, isn't it?
Jim, that's one of the best. You don't see many this outstanding. And these wide receivers, if they can't get two hands on the football, they've taught themselves over time just to go up and stretch as far as they can and get that one hand on it.
Pass is intercepted. And a touchback. Rodgers, completion percentage, 90% on the day. That interception could cost this team big time, Phil, before the intermission, changing momentum and now getting picked off.
Yeah, oh, what a terrible decision. Now the defense is coming on the field and they are mad as can be because they don't understand why was the offense throwing passes in this situation.
The Packers defense, Phil, has been truly dominant here today.
Sometimes when you see a game like this, you go, oh, it might be boring, but this defense has been so dominating and so active in what they're trying to do. It's been fun to watch.
It's a two tight end formation. First down at the 20. Bell's hand at the football.
Bell's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
The first half comes to an end, and this one seems to be already decided. We're watching complete domination play out. Larry is coming up next with the highlights.
Thanks, Jim, and welcome to the EA Sports Halftime Report. Now let's get to it. The Packers have been moving the football at will, and the total yardage numbers stand out. The Lions' defense hasn't been able to get stops, and that inability to get off the field is costing them time and time again. All right, let's get it going. Here's the first half highlights. First and 10, Lacy's going to look for space, but a quick three-play drive ends with the score. The Packers land the first punch. Packers lined up at the 15. The connection is made in the middle of the field, and that goes as a 15-yard touchdown. That puts them on top by 14. Now first and 10, Rodgers got the completion here, and that goes as a 71-yard touchdown. Packers up now by 21. Packers take it at the one. Rodgers finds his mark in coverage, and he caps off the two-play drive with the score. Offense now with the shot after the pick. Rodgers under fire and will throw the pick. Tulloch's the one who makes the pick to give a boost to his defense. So that'll wrap it up for us here at the EA Sports Studio. We'll head back now to Green Bay for the start of the second half.
All right, Larry, thanks a lot. Second half just about to get underway here as the special teams are about to head back onto the field. And he's met head-on right there at the 20. The Lions offense trots out onto the field looking to get into the end zone and see if they can turn the tide in this one, partner.
Well, the fact that they are losing this game so far, the sense of urgency is there on the offensive side. You know, you have many plays in that playbook. I think they need to try a few different ones here in the second half. Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Second down now. Bell's lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. Stafford with the give. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
The Lions take it from the 23. Johnson's going to pull in the bullet pass. That's his first reception today.
Well, that'll make you feel a little better, finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half, and you're on the offensive side. Don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later.
First and 10. Bell's taking the handoff. That's a gain of 6.
Well, he's in the NFL because of this, because this guy can break tackles. Good job on that play.
Second and 3. And a nice catch by Calvin Johnson.
Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do, just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
Handoff made. The Lions trail right now, and you wonder how much the running game stays a part of the game plan. Bell's been shut down from his very first carry on.
No balance by this offense, like you said today. They can't run the football, but I've said this all the time. It's not always about just dominating physically and blocking up front. Running backs have to do their part. They have to make good decisions, and they got to break some tackles. Bell is a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
The offense heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive. The Lions have to get to the 41 for a first. Catch made by Calvin Johnson.
All you can do is your job, and that was a good job by the offense, picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. Hey, don't worry about the score right now. Just find ways to execute plays and get down there and score a touchdown.
Everybody's back out on the field now after that defensive timeout. The line of scrimmage, the 32-yard line. Stafford's setting up now in the pistol.
Now first and 10.
Handoff. Bell's met after a gain of 3.
Bell's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
The Packers defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. The Lions have it at the 29. Bell is tackled down. The fourth quarter about to get underway, and there's not much left to do in this one other than to run out the clock.
Yeah, that's what you hope to do on the side. When you're winning a game like this, you want to run the clock out. And you know what, Jim? On the other side, they want that clock to run too, because they're just trying to find a way to get out of this game.
He'll try this one from 39. The kick is good.
When an offense drives the ball, they always want to get something out of it, get some points. This time, the field goal kicker gets it done. He gives him 3.
The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it. When one quarterback plays well and the other doesn't, that can lead to a pretty one-sided affair like we've had here today.
Yeah, it has been one-sided, but look, there's always reasons why a quarterback plays well or doesn't, Jim. It truly is a team game on the offensive side, and the good numbers come from the offensive line that played well, and the bad numbers come from an offensive line that really struggled here today.
Has Jones. Jones has undoubtedly been the top target for his quarterback today, Phil.
Yeah, he has. And quarterbacks, that's what happens. When a wide receiver gets hot, hey, they'll start looking for him. And that's what's happened in this game so far here.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Rodgers over to Nelson.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion. This offense has been spectacular today, Jim. Here they are in a red zone again.
A power surge for 6. Touchdown. The rest of this quarter is simply a formality.
It's what it looks like, doesn't it? It just looks like, hey, that doesn't even look like it. It is. This game is absolutely over. There's no such thing as a miracle that's going to pull this out for the losing team. But give the offense a lot of credit on the winning side. They have been sharp all day long.
Mason Crosby ready for the kickoff. The same as a touchback as he's tackled right at the 20. The Packers come out in a dime package. Stafford from the gun. Easy catch there. No one near him.
Well, that'll make you feel a little better finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half, and you're on the offensive side. Don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later.
First down at the 35. Looking across the middle, Corey Fuller hauls it in. Fuller's met after a gain of 13. That's another reception, giving him 2.
Well, you play this coverage, cover 4. In other words, you got 4 defenders playing deep, equally spread across the field. Well, who's going to cover the end cuts and underneath? Nobody. That's why the quarterback got an easy completion that time on the in route.
Stafford's completion percentage, 60% on the day.
When receivers are running drag routes across the field, you got to have nice touch and accuracy on the football. That time, the quarterback just throws it too far in front.
Stafford's alone in the backfield. Stafford's back in shotgun formation. Over to Ebron.
I don't know what the answer is when it comes to guarding these tight ends now. There's just not much you can do. I'll tell you the best way to stop the tight end, rush the quarterback.
This next play coming from the 47-yard line. We've hit the two-minute warning in the second half. We return out of the two-minute warning. Fourth quarter action. It'll be third down. The Packers with a nickel look here on defense. Matthew Stafford from the shotgun. Fuller's got it on a pass that had some heat.
When you're getting blown out like this in the second half, get in that hurry-up offense here at the end of the game. Get some practice in it, because I guarantee you, in the weeks coming up, you'll be in this situation, and you'll be glad you worked on your hurry-up offense. Good job by the offense getting in the red zone. Now you're down some points. You got to find a way to score a touchdown.
Surveys. Two hands on the football and has the catch. That's reception number four for him.
Well, that last play almost got him in here. And when you look at this, what do they do? Well, you just want to punch it in. There's a lot of different scenarios. You could do a play-action fake, probably get somebody wide open, or have a running back just jump over the top for the touchdown.
Stafford's completion percentage, 60% on the day. This will be the eighth play of this drive. Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one. They're going to get him here for a sack.
Well, you just get tired of sending three or four players at the quarterback in passing situations. So this time the defensive coordinator sends the blitz, and they are up for it. They get to the QB and get a sack.
The Lions turn the ball over on downs. And that fourth down stop will do it. This game has been over for quite some time, but now they get to finish it off with the exclamation mark.
Yep, they finished it off with style, no doubt about it. Boy, the coaches are going to be happy with the way this team played today in all phases. On the defensive side, they were just short of spectacular.
He's now over 60 yards rushing on the ground.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Airing it out. Puts a hand. Oh, he made the catch. He caught it with one hand. The Packers have created chances for themselves in the passing attack today. Rodgers done everything he can to keep his team on top.
He has been so efficient here today, very smart, making decisions. And when you put those two things together, that's why your football team is winning.
The Packers are going to use one of the two timeouts they have remaining. From the 29-yard line. Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Jordy Nelson with the catch. That's his fourth catch of the day. The Packers will use a timeout here. They'll talk it over before running a play on first down.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Nothing there as this goes for a loss of two.
Well, when you know you can win the game, but just running the football, then you just run the football. Take no chances. Keep two hands around it at all times, and don't worry about the extra yard.
And this will probably wrap things up here. Throws the pass. The reception by Nelson. All that animosity, all that hatred, all the buildup. And in the end, it was a win that was a one-sided affair.
Yeah, it was in all sides. Everything you looked at, they got out hit today. They weren't as physical. They were not smart on the field. Even the design of what they were trying to do, the managing the game, that was wrong on the coaching side. Just one awful effort.
For Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nantz saying so long.